to solving a three-variable system. Okay, solving a three-variable system is tricky, but you know how to do everything I'm about to teach you to do, so don't worry about it. You just need to take your time. There's a lot of room for error, and you don't want to make an error because you want to have to start over, and then that's gonna what's gonna make you want to give up on the problem. I don't need you to give up, so we're gonna take our time from the jump, okay? So let's get started.
Math with Miss B. Math with Miss B. There's a thousand other places that you'd rather be, but you're watching Math with Miss B.
We are going to be solving a three-variable system by elimination, okay? So how to solve a three-variable system? You are going to use equation 1 and 2 to eliminate the third variable, okay? You know how to eliminate variables already. And then you're going to use equation 2 and 3 to eliminate the third variable again. Now you can use other variables, but for the sake of keeping it simple, I'm going to say third variable. Step number 3 is you're going to solve a two-variable system with a new equation. So notice, you already know how to do that. You already know how to solve a two-variable system. So the first two steps are just getting the problem to look like something you already know how to do, which is a lot of what math is. How do I get my problem to look like something I already know how to do? Okay? And then step number 4 is use that two-variable system. Use the two-variable that you solve for to then solve for the third variable, which you should be familiar with, okay? So example number 1. Okay, so when I have example number 1, the first thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna use equation 1 and 2 to eliminate z, okay? So we're gonna take the purple equation and the pink equation, right? So if I'm looking at the purple equation and the pink equation, what I'm noticing, if I'm gonna eliminate z, I have a negative 4 in front of the first z, and then I have a 2 in front of the second z. So I need to think to myself, how would I eliminate those z's? To eliminate, I know I need opposites, right? So I'm gonna need a negative 4, and then that 2, I'm gonna need to turn it into what? A positive 4, good. So what would I do to the pink equation to make that 2 a positive 4? I hope you said multiply by 2, because if you did, then you would be correct. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. And remember, if I multiply one thing, I have to multiply all the things. So I'm multiply the 3x times 2, the 3y times 2, the 2z times 2, and the 3 times 2, baby, okay? So then, once I multiply all those things by 2, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna rewrite my system. So the purple equation stayed the same because I didn't need to multiply it by anything. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring the purple equation down. But now when I multiply everything by 2, that 3x is gonna turn into a 6x, that 3y is gonna turn into a 6y, that 2z is gonna turn into a 4z, which is what I want, and then that negative 3 on the back is gonna turn into a negative 6, right? So once I make that happen, I cancel out or eliminate my z. Okay, so now I got to decide what's going to be left. If once I eliminate my z, then I'm going to go ahead and add down. So 5x plus 6x is going to give me what? 11x. And then negative 2y plus 6y is going to give me 4y. And then 3 minus 6 is going to give me negative 3. So that's my blue equation. So great. We're good to go there. I only have two variables. That's what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna use equation 2 and 3 and we're gonna eliminate z. Okay, so this time we're gonna use the pink equation and the orange equation. Okay, so looking at the z's, I have a 2 and then I have a 3. Okay, so what number can I turn 2 and 3 into? Did you say 6? Good job! Yes, I can turn them into 6. So to turn a 2 into 6, what am I going to go ahead and do? I'm going to multiply the top equation by negative 3. And I'm going to go ahead and multiply the bottom equation by what? Positive 2. Good. So once I do that, I'm going to go ahead and draw my little line. right? And I'm going to rewrite my systems. So the pink equation, instead of being 3x, is going to be negative 9x. Instead of being 3y, it's going to be negative 9y. Instead of being positive 2z, it's going to be negative 6z equals. Instead of negative 3, it's going to be positive 9, because I multiplied everything in that equation by negative 3. So then, for the second equation, the orange equation, when I multiply, what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and change everything. So instead of 2, it's going to be a 4, negative 4. Instead of a 5, it's going to be a 10. Instead of a 3, it's going to be a 6. And instead of a 3, it's going to be a 6 at the end. So now what can I do with my z's? Because the whole point of this was to do what? It was to eliminate the z, eliminate that third variable, right? So I have a negative 6 and a positive 6. So what happens now? Good. They're going to go ahead and eliminate. So now I'm going to draw my little line, and then we're going to figure out what's going to be left in the equation, right? So if I do negative 9 and then negative 4x, what am I going to get, right? I'm going to get negative 13x. And then if I do negative 9 and then positive 10y, what am I going to get? I'm going to just get 1y left. We don't need the 1 there, but I wrote it anyway, okay? And then I'm going to do the 9 equals 9 plus 6, and then that's going to give me 15. So now I have my blue equation and my black equation. They both only have 2 variables. This is what I want. Okay? So now we're going to use these 2 new equations to solve a 2 variable system, which you already know how to do. Okay, so now that I've simplified, here we go. Okay, so these are my 2 variable. This is my 2 variable system. So you could go back to solving systems like normal and do this problem from the start. Which variable do we want to eliminate? I'm looking at the blue and then the black. I think I'm going to want to eliminate the y, right? Because there's no coefficient in front of the y, so that would be easy. All I have to do is, if this is a positive 4, to make it a negative 4, all I got to do is multiply the black equation by negative 4. So that's what we're going to go ahead and do. Negative 4, negative 4, negative 4. Okay? I'm going to draw my line, and now what am I going to do? Think about it. Process it before I do it. What do I do now? Rewrite the equations. Very good. So I didn't do nothing with the blue equation, right? So we're gonna rewrite that. But the black equation changes because I multiplied everything by a negative 4. So I have 52y negative 4y equals negative 60. I'm gonna give you a minute. Process. Take a deep breath. It's all right. So now that I have that working out for me, okay? 52x minus 4y equals negative 60. What happens now? Good. We're going to cancel out. Okay? So once I cancel out, this is good for me. I'm going to get 63x equals negative 63. Now, we got to think about this. What does 63, how do I get x by itself? Well, I'm going to divide by 63, right? So divide by 63, divide by 63. What is x going to equal, everybody? I have a negative 63 divided by a positive 63. X is going to equal negative 1. I have 1 variable. Yes! Finish solving the 2 variable system. Now I'm going to solve for y, okay? So now that I'm solving for y, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to plug in that x value, okay? I'm going to plug it into either one of my equations. I could plug it into the blue one or I could plug it into the black one. It doesn't matter which one I plug it into, but I'm going to choose to plug it into the black one, right? So when I plug it into the black one, this is what I'm going to notice. I'm going to notice that I'm going to get a negative 13y parentheses negative 1 plus y equals 15. So when I do that, I'm going to simplify negative 13 times negative 1, and that's going to give me positive 13 plus y equals 15. So once I do that, I'm going to solve for y. So when I solve for y, that means I'm going to be negative 13 minus 13 on both sides. And then that's going to give me what? Y equals 2. So now I have 2 variables. I have an x and a y. Now my job is easy. As soon as I get an x and a y. I'm going to pick one of my equations from the original problem, okay, which is that big old system that we originally started off with the purple, the pink, and the orange, okay? And I'm going to choose one of my equations, and I'm going to go ahead and plug x and y into one of my equations. I'm going to pick the purple one, just because, but I could pick the pink or I could pick the orange one, okay? So we pick the purple one, so instead of an x, I'm going to use a negative 1. Instead of a y, I'm going to use a 2. So I'm going to simplify. So 5 times negative 1 is going to give me negative 5, and then negative 2 times negative 2 is going to give me, negative 2 times positive 2 is going to give me a negative 4. Minus 4z equals positive 3. So I'm going to combine like terms now. Negative 9 minus 4z. I need to get the z by itself. So obviously what I'm going to do is I'm going to add 9 to both sides. Negative 4z equals 12. And last but not least, what shall we do? We're going to divide, of course. And then x or z equals negative 3. So I have all three of my answers now. I have x equals negative 1, I have y equals 2, and I have z equals negative 3. Moving on to example number 2. Okay, same rules apply. Okay, I am going to use equation 1 and 2 to eliminate z. We have 4 examples, by the way. I know that's a lot, but it's fine. Okay, so I have equation 1 and equation 2, and I need to eliminate z. But what I notice about the z's is I have a positive z and I have a negative z. So already I have opposites. That is so nice. So all I have to go ahead and do is I can go ahead right there, right then and there, and swipe them out. Once I swipe them out, I'm going to add what I have left, right? So I have x plus 3x gives me 4x, and then 4y plus 2y equals 6y equals, and then on the other side, the 28 plus the 8 is gonna give me the 28. Bada bing, bada boom. Okay, so now once I've done that, I have to do it again with the second two equations. So I have to do the 3x plus 2y, the pink equation, and then the 2x minus 3y, the orange equation, okay? Because I have to eliminate z. So we're going to take the pink equation, and we're going to take the orange equation, and we are going to, we're going to eliminate the z. So when I'm looking at the pink equation and the orange equation, I have a pink, the pink one has a coefficient of 1 in front of the z, and then the orange one has a coefficient of 2 in front of the z. So the question that you need to ask yourself is, what do I need to multiply to get those coefficients to match? So I want you to think about that. Okay, so if you decided to multiply the pink equation by negative 2, you would be absolutely correct. Okay, so that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to multiply the pink equation by negative 2. And so now that we've decided that that's what we're going to do, we need to rewrite our system. So I'm going to rewrite the top equation by multiplying everything by negative 2. I'm going to give you a moment, though, to think about what that's going to be. So when I do that, I'm going to get negative 6 minus 4y minus 2z equals negative 16. Did we do anything to the orange equation? No. So the orange equation is going to go ahead and stay the same. So now that I've done that, what can I do with my problem now? Well, of course, what I can do is I can eliminate my variables, which is exactly what we wanted to do in the first place. So now that I'm eliminating my variables, I have to decide what is left. And that's going to be negative 4y, negative 7y equals negative 32. So I'm going to use the blue equation and the black equation. And now I'm just going to solve a regular two-variable system by solving the blue equation with the black equation. Because that's exactly what I wanted. All right, so we're taking the blue equation and the black equation, and we need to solve. Okay? So notice that already my coefficients are opposites of each other for the x's. So I already have a positive 4 and a negative 4 for my x's, which makes my job way too easy. So all I have to do is cancel those out and bring down what's left. So 6 minus 7y is going to give me negative y equals 28 minus 32, going to give me negative 4. So I'm going to have negative y equals negative 4. So I need to get that to be a positive y. So obviously we're going to divide by negative 1. And when I divide by negative 1, I'm going to get y equals positive 4. So I have one variable. Once I have one variable, I'm good. So I'm going to take that y. We're going to take one of the equations. It could be the blue one or the black one. Doesn't matter. And in this case, I decided to choose the black one. So we chose the black one and I plugged in the 4. So when I plugged in that 4, I'm going to multiply the negative 7 times the 4. That's going to give me negative 28. And I'm going to solve the equation. Super easy for me to be able to figure out what x is. So plus 28 on both sides. Great. I get 4x equals negative 4. Divide by negative 4 on both sides. I'm going to get x equals 1. Okay? So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my original system. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to plug in that 1 and we're going to plug in that 4. To the equation, and when we do that, we're going to simplify, so I'll get 1 plus 16, and then that would be 17, subtract 17 for both sides. I'm going to get negative z equals 3, but I can't have a negative z, it needs to be a positive, so that's going to be negative 1, negative 1, and then z equals negative 3, and once we have that, those are our solutions. X equals 1. Y equals 4, z equals negative 3. Okay, example number 3 in the building. All right, so again, we're gonna use equation 1 and equation 2 to eliminate T. So that's purple and pink, right? So lucky for us, look what happened. We already have opposites for T, which we love to see. Okay, so I'm going to get rid of my opposites, and then I'm going to add down. So I'm going to get negative 10R plus 8S equals negative 34. Okay, so then use equation 2 and 3 to eliminate T. So once I do that, I'm going to get the pink equation, the orange equation, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to figure out how to get opposites. I have a negative 3 and a positive 6 for my coefficients. So which equation are we going to multiply? Everybody should have said the top equation. That's good. Okay, so then what am I going to multiply the top equation by? 2. Perfect. So everything by 2, by 2, by 2. Fantastic. We're going to rewrite our system. So the pink equation, everything got multiplied by 2. So negative 5 turned into negative 10. 3 turned into 6. Negative 3 turned into negative 6. And then negative 11 turned into positive 2. Turned into negative 22. And then the orange equation stays the same. Now I have opposites, which is exactly what my goal was. We wanted opposites. So that means that I'm going to go ahead and I am going to swipe out my opposites. Swipe, swipe. Swipe or no swiping. I don't know if that's Dora. Okay, so once I do that, I'm going to get negative 16R plus 6X equals negative 34. And so now I have two variable equations, which is what I want, because I need to use the blue equation and the black equation to be my new system of two variable equations. Okay. So now that I'm looking at my new system, I need to cancel out one of the variables or eliminate one of the variables. Which one am I gonna use? It honestly doesn't matter whether you use the R's or the S's. Because they're both going to be equally as challenging. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we are going to use the S's because the numbers are smaller. So I multiply everything in the bottom one by 8, multiply everything in the top one by -6, because I need them to be opposites. -6, because I need them to be opposites. Okay, so I'm gonna rewrite the equation now. So positive 60, negative 48, 204. You see these big numbers? They would have been bigger. Okay, so then I'm gonna do negative 128 plus 48s equals negative 242. Big ol' numbers. Okay, so now what's gonna happen is I'm gonna swipe out my opposites. The 48s cancel out, which is what I want. I'm gonna add everything else down. So 60R minus 128R equals negative 68R. Equals on the other side, 204 minus 272 equals negative 68. Well, big numbers, still everything's gonna go ahead and cancel out. So I'm gonna divide by negative 68. Negative 68. Negative divided by negative equals a positive R. Yay! Okay, so normally what would happen is I would go ahead and I would use one of my blue or black equations to substitute R in, but I'm actually not gonna do that. I'm gonna take the orange equation from the original because the numbers are smaller, and I'm gonna plug that in for R. Yes, I am. Okay, so once I do that, I'm gonna plug in the blue R. I'm gonna get negative 6, but I gotta get rid of it. So add 6 on both sides. Then we're gonna get 60 equals negative 6. Once I do that, I'm gonna divide by 6, divide by 6. T equals negative 1. Okay, good. So now that I have two of my variables, we're gonna bring back our original problem, and we're gonna choose one of the equations to substitute R and T. Once I do that, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna choose the pink equation. I'm gonna substitute R and T. We gotta find S. Make sure you're paying attention to where you're plugging your numbers in, because I think I messed this problem up like 3 times because I was plugging in R's into S's and stuff like that. So make sure you're careful, careful, careful. Okay, so once I simplify, negative 5 and 3 is gonna be negative 2. And so now, once I combine my like terms, I'm gonna get S by itself. Plus 2, plus 2, 3s equals negative 9. S equals negative 3. So now I have all three of my variables. Yay! Okay, so once I have all three of my variables, those are my solutions, baby. Any questions? I feel like I'm actually teaching. Okay, last example, I know. Whew, everybody take a deep breath. We're almost okay. First of all, you're going to use equation 1 and 2. Are you surprised? No, because we've been doing this. Okay, so we use equation 1 and 2, and we got to get opposites for z because we got to eliminate the z variable, right? So I have a 3 and I have a negative 1. So one's positive, one's negative already. Great. So which equation are we going to multiply? Oh, good. The bottom equation by 3. Good. So then I'm going to rewrite. The top one didn't change, so we're going to leave that one the same. And then the bottom equation, we're going to multiply. So it's 3x, 6y, minus 3z equals 0. Because anything times 0 is still 0. Okay. So now I have opposites. Yes. So I'm going to add down 2 plus 3 is 5. Negative 4 plus 6 is 2y equals 17. So I have one equation. Now, I'm going to eliminate the second two. So now we're going to use the pink and the orange. Okay, so we got pink, orange. What I notice about my z's is both of them are negative. They can't cancel out if both of them are negative. One of them has to be negative. One of them has to be positive. Okay. So if one is negative, one is positive. So I'm gonna go ahead and multiply the top equation by negative 1 to make it positive. So I'm gonna rewrite that. And when I rewrite that, I'm gonna get negative x minus 2y plus z equals 0. So now I'm going to do I'm gonna cancel them out, which is what I want, and I'm gonna add down. So negative 1 plus 4 equals 3x, negative 2 minus y equals negative 3y, and then 0 plus 6 equals 6. So now I have my two variable equations. That's what I want. I want two variable equations so that I could do the dang thing, okay? Because we know how to solve these when there are two variables. Okay, so looking at my blue and my black, I need to cancel out. So I'm gonna go ahead and multiply. My equation by 3 and then by 2. And once I do that, I get my new equations. I mean, by 3 and then by 5, my bad, 3 and 5. I don't know why I said that. I was looking at the y's. But anyway, so I did by 3s and by the 5s. So I'm going to go ahead, and now that I got my opposites, I'm going to swipe out, and I'm going to be left with 21y equals 21. I like that because that's easy. 21 divided by 21, y equals 1. I'm going to take one of my original two variable equations, okay, which in this case I took the black one. I'm going to plug in my y. Once I plug in my y, I simplify, and then I get a plus 3. To cancel out, divide by 3, divide by 3, x equals 3. And now I'm going to use my original equation. Okay, we're going to pick one of our problems, doesn't matter which one. In this case, I picked the pink one. And I'm going to plug in the 3, and I'm going to plug in the 1. Once I plug in the 3, plug in the 1, I'm going to simplify. And then once I simplify, I get 5. So I need to get rid of that 5 to get z by itself. And then negative z equals negative 5. So I divide by negative 1. So z equals 5. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is our final answer. Okay. I'm going to do what I always do, which is I'm going to say you should go back to this video and pause it before I do the work and see if you could do the examples on your own. I know, by yourself, because they're complicated, right? Like, you're looking at me and you're like, yeah, I could do that. But you haven't done it yet. So try it on your own, okay? Take out a sheet of paper, get it together. And if not, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.